What?
Boy, I don't think they're ready for this.
These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. Pull up on them and it look nice, look nice.
These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future.
Yeah, we look nice, future looking nice. We don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Yeah, we look nice, future looking real nice. We don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Good afternoon and welcome to Gosford for match day 5 of the Isuzu Ute A-League Men's as the Central Coast Mariners host Western Sydney Wanderers. Inspirational captain Ollie Bozanic plays his 100th A-League Men's match for the club, becoming the 11th player to do so. Nikolai Muller could make his Mariners debut from the bench against his former team. And after he finished up with Hearts in Scotland last year, Ollie Bozanic returned home to Terrigal. He was doing some sessions with the Mariners to keep fit when he realised, I might stick around. And now he plays his 100th A-League men's match for the club. He is the heartbeat of the side. For Western Sydney, just the one change for Carl Robinson's Wanderers after that 2-0 defeat to the Bulls. So Tom Ahmed returns. He scored 8 goals in his last 8 in the A-League men's. That means Dimi Petratos drops to the bench. Bernie Abini will meet the club he made his A-League men's debut for back in 2010. He played 77 matches for the Mariners and scored 22 goals. So Wanderers get us underway as they look to extinguish the outside noise with a strong performance on the coast. Central Coast Mariners looking to make it back-to-back wins alongside for the call. It's a very good afternoon to Daniel McBrain.
Good afternoon, Ben. Welcome, everybody. As you've mentioned, a massive game for both clubs. Central Coast Mariners looking to build on that last week's impressive performance against Sydney FC. Really came out of the blocks and dominated early. Took the game by the scruff of the neck. And Western Sydney Wanderers, there's been plenty of talk around their opening stanza of the season, the FA Cup exit, last week's loss as well. So plenty to play for both teams.
And defensively so impressive again last week, the Mariners' backline. Now at the other end, Nisbet cutting it across to Urania, who strikes it wide. So what an opportunity again there for the Central Coast early on in the match, and all built on the back of Josh Nisbet's speed down the right.
Well, he had a fantastic game last week, didn't he? And it's route one, straight in behind. And as he has a little look over his shoulder there, cuts it back to this man, Urania, who had a fantastic game last week.
Troisi searching for Ogawa. Here's Nisbet finding Urania. Marco Urania just too far in front of Moresh.
That's the second time now we've seen the Mariners get in down this right-hand side. And it's a great front from Urania. He just slides that ball across. You can't ask much more.
Antonis. Hemed, good link-up to Terry Antonis. Ogawa! Flashes across Birigidi's goal, and we are going to have the first drinks break. It's a dangerously bending ball from Troisi, and just shielded back to Birigidi. Continuing the run, stabs it for Goddard. Now Urania, space aplenty for Marco Urania. He knows he can produce better than that.
But again, it's all just a little too easy.
What do you make of the lack of pressure on the ball at times, Macca? Do you put that down to the heat?
Yeah,
see Aquilina sliding in Ogawa, and Rolls dealt with comfortably.
Yeah, I do, man. I think the fact that it's hot, the team wants to really drop back, protect their box, rather than get caught higher up and then have to chase them. You don't want the game to really open up end to end. And you see a great run in behind from Ogawa. Again, Rolls Johnny on the spot to get it away. But yeah, I think the temperature is having an effect on the game.
Troisi. Here is Antonis. And pushing it well wide in the end. And some respite the players have got from the heat, with the sun just ducking behind the clouds. Of course, still very humid.
Well, Western Sydney here are really controlling the game, the tempo at the moment. Lots of possession in the opposition half, but still forced to take shots from outside the box.
Abini. Ahead of Hall, only as far as Antonis. Ugarkovic fizzes away from Mark Birigidi's goal. But again, shooting from outside the box, Western Sydney.
Yeah, but it's sustained pressure now. Mariners not really getting any time on the ball. Western Sydney keep coming at them, keep having that good field position.
Maka is Nisbet. He's looking it to Goddard. Urena on the outside, and the touch too heavy. Marco Urena just looks a little off this afternoon.
Straight to the point, was he?
Don't muck around. Ogawa. And just over the head of Hemed. Troisi's going to catch up with it. And Josh Nisbet. How good is that from Joshy Nisbet? Pinches the ball off Troisi and rushes away downfield. And then, unfortunately for the home side, Miller just scuffs it over the sideline. Troisi now has the ball picked off by Maresch. Urena. The two front men trying to link up here. Foot race between Urena and Katrumbas, and Urena wins out. Nisbet arriving. And Maresch got some gun power behind that one.
If you just go back to the lead-up play in that opportunity for the Mariners, you see a great foot race between Urena and Katrumbas. You probably see something similar here, but this is what I like to see. Urena peeling off under Reece Williams. Katrumbas is a very quick player. I like to see Urena like this, isolate himself.
Urena. And now Bozanic. We've seen him bend it in from there before, and the captain in game number 100 for the Central Coast will be so disappointed he didn't cap the milestone match.
You can see the Harvey Norman replay here. Oli Bozanic is looking to bend that into the far bottom corner, and you can see Mahias, he's just looking, he's standing, he's hoping it goes wide.
So Mariners now enjoying a spell in possession. It's been Wanderers for much of this first half. To Nisbet. There's the captain, Oli Bozanic. Always there to mop up when required. And Josh Nisbet could scrape it across with Johnny Katrumbas smothering his crossing angle, but he has won a corner for the Mariners.
Another great run from Nisbet in behind. If it's not Urena, it's Nisbet. Always a willing runner. Good ball from Miller. Just waited a little too long there and gave Katrumbas the opportunity to win the tackle.
Yes. Comfortably claims it.
You flip that for the Mariners and you've got Urena. You've got Nisbet. You can see again now Goddard looking to make runs in behind, which creates these space.
Urena, and again, he just is not quite there today, Marco Urena. Again, he gets the service, and he can't put Pierce under pressure.
Well, again, it's the great movement. Sai Goddard going forward creates the space inside. And again, Urena, he won't be happy with his finish.
It'll be a big second half on the way. Wanderers want to avoid three straight defeats across all competitions. The Mariners looking for back-to-back wins. Both here at home. Troisi through the legs of Miller, and it got really tricky on Urigidi. So a corner is the end result for Wanderers as the ball just deflected through the legs of Lewis Miller.
Well, it looked like the deflected cross was going to draw harmlessly to Birigidi, but Hemed was having none of it.
So a tight first 45 minutes in Gosford. Chances at both ends. But for Marco Urrenia, who loves playing in Gosford, he hasn't quite brought his shooting boots today. It's been about Kai Rolls at the back for the Mariners, who again is performing well alongside, of course, the youngster Jacob Farrell. Central Coast Mariners and Western Sydney locked up at 0-0 at half time. So Lachlan Kiefer sends us on our way. The second half underway in Gosford, and it's the Mariners targeting 3 points for the second week in a row. Who get us started in their white kit, of course. Payne as Goddard trying to cut it across the goal line. Of course, paying tribute to their academy teams, the Central Coast Mariners, this afternoon with this kit. And pretty good afternoon, Daniel McBrain, to be wearing it on a warm, sunny Saturday afternoon in Gosford. Bounced up neatly there for Ogawa. Abini. And it breaks down for Wanderers. Now Marco Urrenia. Now he lines it up again, flashes wide, but that's as close as he has come.
Well, it was a sloppy turnover from Western Sydney Wanderers. And Goddard turned, played the ball forward, and Urrenia spun. And we spoke about him pulling up the shoulder of Reece Williams, just not quite finding that finishing touch. I just wonder if Carl Robinson will look to his bench. There's a number of players that can create in small areas.
Well, problems for Wanderers, and Kai Rolls just rushing right through the heart of their defence. And here's Urrenia behind him. Nisbet! How has he put that wide, Josh Nisbet? Terry Antona still prone on the turf. The ball wasn't put out, and the Mariners should have made it 1-0.
Well, it all started with the ball being given away up the other end, and the Mariners came in numbers. And as Josh Nisbet pulled that back on his left foot, the next thing you thought you'd see is the net rippling.
Troisi off the head of Dan Hall. It's Fijian heritage just Dan Hall, and said he would consider playing for the national team. Urrenia taken down by Williams, and that has stung the Costa Rican. Is it enough to earn a yellow card? It is for the Wanderers skipper. For Zanuck, Miller just didn't get the purchase on the header. He was totally free. Lewis Miller looking for his first goal in the Isuzu Ute A-League men's. And swiftly, Wanderers, well, look to be on the counter, but instead going to go again here through Troisi. And that just shows a lack of ideas for Wanderers.
See that ball come in. Miller just got himself up a little too early, actually, and as the ball dipped, he couldn't get down and get the power into it. I wonder if Carl Robinson's going to look to those players to really inject something, because it has been really stale in that front third for Western Sydney.
Well, that's the thing, Macca, if you... Abini, finding Aquilina, and now Hemed. Here is Antonis. Just had the wedge out. Up and over goal, but it was better build up from Western Sydney.
It was better from Aquilina. You see here, this is the run in behind. Get in behind, and that's when you'll cause problems. And he's finally made a run in behind, and he's opened things up. Drag that Central Coast defence out of play. Now you've got the opportunity to get strikes on, but they need more of that.
Yeah, you're talking about Troisi and his creativity. You know, you could almost say the conductor in midfield, but it's difficult if the band is not going to play, as Nisbet slipping out wide to Miller. And now he's Goddard! Finally, the Central Coast Mariners get one on target. And Cy Goddard with his first goal in the A-League men's. And the 15 minutes at the start of the second half comes up trumps again for the Mariners.
Well, it was all so simple, wasn't it? And the Harvey Norman replay as they drive forward. It's played out wide and it's just deflected, and Cy Goddard just waltzed in at the back post. Stretching on that left foot, up underneath the bar, down into the goal. You see Nisbet assessing the situation. Miller always looking to get forward. And that's a thunderous finish. And there's nothing that Mejias can do about that. And it's 1-0 Mariners.
Wanderers have got three men ready. You can see Petratos, Russell and Moutakoudis. So that shows you how frustrated Carl Robinson is with his team at the moment. Making three changes just after the hour mark. Of course it is hot as well, but three-prong change, he is hoping will turn the tide in Wanderers' favour. Perfect afternoon to display just how strong this academy is. Harry Steele, who's come through that system, replaced by another man who's come through the Central Coast Mariners Academy, Max Ballard, the 21-year-old out there. And Ballard wins the ball from Troisi. Urena running at Williams. Marco Urena testing out Mejias and draws a save and a corner.
Well, he's done well again there. Urena, as he received this ball, he looked up, assessed the situation and said, well, 1v1, let's go. Forced a great save down to his left from Mejias. That's going in the bottom corner, I believe. And as all good strikers do, he keeps on coming.
Goddard and a punch from Mejias, the former Real Madrid keeper. And they give it away again. Western City, look at Bozanic, just looks to have so much time on the ball. Ballard. You just think about the experience for Max Ballard and the likes of Harry Steele as well to play alongside Bozanic. Now Miller across again. Williams takes the safety first approach. He looks a frustrated man. This is a crucial moment in the match. Dan Hall looks to flick it goalwards. Troisi off the back of Goddard. And now Ballard. And Miller goes down in the box and he is going to get booked here for simulation.
As we look here, look, bodies everywhere. I think, yeah, he's gone down easily there. Difficult angle to see the touch. Plenty of players around. Did go down quite easily.
So it's Nikolai Muller who went the other way to Ziggy Gordon. He was at Wanderers and now comes to Central Coast this season. So he makes his Mariners debut. 7 in 37 for Wanderers and has been hindered this season by a hamstring injury. That's why we have had to wait to see Nikolai Muller in Mariners colours. And the goal scorer Cy Goddard is going to be replaced by him. Benny Nkololo also out there, the Frenchman. And this is the difference between the two sides at the moment. Cy Goddard with his first goal for the club. Trumbus and Russell. And Troisi. This is better. Petratos. Petratos opens up the space finally. And Birri. Arrigidi made himself big. And that is the sign of a great goalkeeper. Called upon at a crucial moment, and he comes up with an important save. Storm Roux and Manny Agüek getting ready, and it will be Manny Agüek's first appearance for the Central Coast Mariners. What a season he had in the NPL 3 in Victoria. 12 goals in 14 matches for Western United. He's played a couple of A-League men's matches last season for Western. So Storm Roux on his way onto Central Coast Stadium. Played the first three matches of the season from the start, and then off the bench the last couple. Lewis Miller preferred to start over Storm Roux, and Lewis Miller again today. The ball to set up Cy Goddard's goal. And Marco Urena, another strong performance. Of course, he'll wish he had have grabbed a goal. He probably should have. He played his part again. So Manny Agüek, who was born in Sudan and moved to Australia in 2004, grew up in the west of Melbourne and now making the move to the central coast of New South Wales. As Nikolai Muller again fouled, so no love lost between Muller and his former club.
Only to be expected that, Benny, but also frustration, you know, you're down. Just a little lean, little shoulder in the back.
Pitches the ball off Petratos. Nisbet. Looks as though it's go to the corner option for the Mariners. Agüek maybe not. Nisbet. This should be a... Well, it is now. It took a while. And this could be the final chance of what has been a frustrating afternoon for Western Sydney Wanderers.
Well, he just fell over on the first opportunity, got back up.
So it is the captain in his 100th match for the Central Coast Mariners. Oli Bozanic delivers once again. What a star he is for the Central Coast Mariners. And that is a captain's goal to savour and puts the icing on a very pretty cake for the Central Coast Mariners.
The Harvey Norman replay had to be Oli Bozanic, the leader of this team, stood over the ball, said everyone get away. And we talk about the final nail in the coffin. Well, wham, there it is.
And Nick Montgomery's side wins back-to-back matches. Sydney FC last week, Western Sydney Wanderers this week. Full-time in Gosford, Central Coast Mariners 2, Western Sydney Wanderers 0.